As you might know, I love working with all kinds of motors, and thus it is also often necessary to alter their RPM, aka revolutions per minute, which is the number of turns the motor shaft executes in 1 minute. To do that with DC motors, you just need to change the average voltage level. And for BLDC motors, it is pretty much the same thing, just way more complicated. But while altering the RPM, there's a good chance you might want to measure it as well. And that is why I got myself this tachometer a while ago. It is the HP7236C, which you can get for around 29 euros from eBay. And yes, I know, that is kind of cheap for a tachometer in comparison to others. And thus, my expectations were not too high. But oh boy, hold on to your hats, because in this episode of DIY or Buy, I will not only show you why this tachometer is almost unusable, but also how a 3 euro sensor can do its job 10 times better, and how we can turn this sensor into our own DIY tachometer that gets the job done. Let's get started! This video is sponsored by JLC PCB. Feel free to visit their website jlcpcb.com to not only find out what awesome PCB and assembly services they offer, but also to easily upload your Gerber files and thus order affordable and high quality PCBs quickly. First off, let's talk about the positive aspects of this tachometer, which are that the overall build quality is pretty decent. It uses a laser for the measurements, which sounded promising. It can not only measure the RPM optically, but also with contact through the help of one of those roller adapters. And it can also measure the speed or travel distance through the help of another roller adapter. All in all, it sounded like a product that can do lots of things for a small price tag. So let's start testing it by firstly covering the whole shaft of my DC motor with black electrical tape and then adding a small piece of white tape to it. We need this preparation because the tachometer basically measures how often its laser beam gets reflected by the shafts in order to calculate the RPM. The black tape obviously absorbs more light than the white tape, and thus this setup should theoretically work out. And if we use the optical RPM mode of the tachometer, then we can see that we get a value of around 300 RPM. Next, I added the contact measurement adapter to the tachometer, onto which I pushed the roller adapter in order to measure the RPM in contact mode. And as you can see, this time we are measuring a value of 150 RPM. First off, isn't it lovely when a product delivers two different measurements for the same thing? And secondly, which one of those values is now correct? To find that out, I simply filmed my rotating DC motor in slow motion, and then used my editing software to count the frames it takes to complete one rotation. And after a couple of calculations, we got an RPM value of 230. Which means both previous values were incorrect. Now, you might be thinking, well, maybe the DC motor is just too slow. Maybe the tachometer only works with a high RPM. Well, I tried the same measurements with my BLDC motor, which gave me values of 960 RPM optically and 600 RPM through contacts. And after doing my Inspector Gadget editing software technique, I calculated an RPM of 857, which means that once again both measurements were incorrect. So if you're looking for a tachometer that hints you in the right RPM region, then this tachometer is for you. But for everyone else, I would recommend this IR distance sensor that you can get from eBay for just 3 euro. To understand its functional principle, I first used my multimeter to reverse engineer its circuit, and came up with this schematic. To start off though, we can power up the circuit with a DC voltage of 3.3 volts. We can see that the red power LED lights up, while the green LED only lights up when we bring an object close enough to the two LEDs in the front. The reason is that not only the power LED got powered, but also the infrared light LED in the front, which now constantly emits infrared light. When an object gets too close to it, the infrared light bounces back into the infrared photoreceiver, which is connected to the non-inverting inputs of a comparator IC. The inverting input of this comparator is connected to a potentiometer on the PCB that we can adjust to set a voltage level, which defines the distance at which the sensor reacts to objects. So when no IR light falls into the photoreceiver, then it is non-conductive, and the supply voltage is basically present at the non-inverting input. That means, since the non-inverting input features a higher voltage than the inverting input, the output is pulled up to the supply voltage, and thus the green LED does not light up. But if an object gets close and IR light hits the photoreceiver, it becomes conductive, and thus current can flow through it, and the voltage at the non-inverting input decreases. Now the voltage at the inverting input is higher, and thus the output gets pulled down to ground, and the green LED lights up. So if we connect the output pin to an oscilloscope and bring the sensor close to the rotating DC motor shaft, then we can see that we're getting a beautiful square wave. The high state represents the black tape where most light got absorbed, and the low state represents the white tape where most light got reflected. And by measuring the frequency, we get a value of around 3.9 Hz, which converted into RPM equals the same RPM we calculated before with the editing software. Perfect! Even measuring the highest possible RPM of my BLDC motor was not a problem for the sensor, which spat out a frequency of around 94 Hz, so around 5640 RPM. According to the kV rating of the motor and the voltage I've been powering it with, that should also be a pretty decent measurement. So, all in all, this little sensor is awesome. And to turn it into a proper tachometer, all we need is a handful of components, like an Arduino Pro Mini, an OLED display, and a LiPo battery with hooked up charge and protection circuit, along with a small power switch. According to this finalized schematic, I soldered all of those components to a piece of perf board before I connected them to one another through solder bridges and wires. And if you want to create such a super simple tachometer on your own, then you can find the schematic along with the code and more information as always in the video description. But anyway, after an hour of soldering and bringing the perf boards into a nicer shape, the hardware setup was basically complete, and thus I created a bit of code for the Arduino. What I was using to make it all work was an external interrupt and the timer 1 of the microcontroller. Simplified speaking, as soon as the sensor output pin gets pulled low, the external interrupt gets activated, which resets the 16-bit timer 1 counter register. This timer now counts up until the output pin gets once again pulled low, at which point the counter register value gets saved into another variable before once again resetting. Since we use the prescaler of 256, we know that a value of 31,250 would equal 1 second. And thus, through a simple calculation, we can find out the time one rotation of the rotor required. And if you're completely confused right now, I would recommend watching my video about timers, in which I explain way more about the subject. But anyway, by dividing 60 seconds through this time duration of one turn, we basically got the RPM, and that's it. Since we use the 16-bit counter that can store 65,535 values, we should be able to measure a minimum of 29 RPM and a theoretical, never practically reachable maximum of 1,875,000 RPM. So, after uploading this code through the help of an FTDI breakout, you can not only see that I also included a function that states slow if we measure a too slow or no RPM, but also that my tachometer does work without any problems. Now, of course, you could fine-tune the code a bit in order to smooth out the RPM value. But nevertheless, all in all, I'm rather happy with my DIY solution, which only cost me around 20 euro to make. And that is also why for me, DIY is this time the clear winner. And with that being said, I hope you enjoyed this video. If so, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Stay creative, and I will see you next time!